gosh, this smells good. Come up to the fire, ladies.
I'm not cold.
No, Mr. Hale. Before we move things about, you explain to Mr. Henderson just what you saw when you come here yesterday morning.
By the way, has anything been moved? I think just as you left them yesterday.
It's just the same. When it dropped below zero last night, I thought that I'd be better send Frank out this morning to make a fire for us. I'm just getting pneumonia with a big case on, but I told him not touch anything except the stuff, and you know, Frank.
Somebody should have been left here yesterday.
Yesterday? When I had to send Frank to Maori Center for that man who went crazy, I want you to know I had my hands full yesterday. I knew you could get back from Omaha by today, and as long as I went over everything here myself.
Well, Mr. Howe, so tell us what happened when you came here yesterday morning.
Harry and I had started to town with a lot of potatoes. We came along the road from my place, and I got here. I said, I'm going to see if I can get John Wright to go in with me on a party telephone. I spoke to Wright about it once before, and he put me out saying folk talk too much anyway, and all he asked was peace and quiet. I guess you know about how much he talked himself. But I thought maybe if I went to the house and talk about it before his wife. So I said to Harry that I didn't know as what his wife wanted made difference to John.
Let's talk about that later, Mr. Howell. I did want to talk about that, but so much will happen when you got here, you got to the house.
I didn't hear or see anything. I knocked at the door, and still it was all quiet inside. I knew they must be up. It was past 8 o'clock, so I knocked again, and I thought I heard somebody say, "Come in." I wasn't sure. I'm not sure yet, but I opened the door, this door, and there in that rocker sat Mrs. Wright.
What was she doing?
She was rocking back and forth. She had her apron in her hand and was kind of plaiting it.
And how did she look?
Well, she looked queer.
How do you mean queer?
Well, asked if she didn't know what she was going to do next and kind of tone up.
How did she seem to feel about your coming?
Well, I don't think she minded one way or other. She didn't pay much attention. I said, "How do Mrs. Ryan, it's cold, ain't it?" And she said, "Is it?" And went on kind of plaiting at her apron. Well, I was surprised she didn't ask me to come up to the stove or to sit down, but just sat there, not even looking at me, so I said, "I want to see John." And then she laughed. I guess she would call it love. I thought of hearing the theme also, so I said a little sharp, "Can I see John?" "No," says she, kind of dull like. "And he home," says I. "Yes," says she, "he's home." "Then why can't I see him?" I asked her out of patience. "Cause he's dead." "J.G., Dad," says I. She just nodded her head, not getting a bit excited, but rocking back and forth. "Why, where is she?" says I, not knowing what to say. She just pointed upstairs like that. I got up with the idea of going up there. I walked from there to here. Then I say, "Why, what did he die of?" "He died of a rope around his neck," says she, and just went on plaiting at her apron. Well, I went out and called Harry. I thought I might need help. We went upstairs and there he was lying.
Well, you know, Mr. Howe, I think what would the help you go into that upstairs so you can't find it all and just go on now with the rest of the story, right?
Well, my first thought was to get it rough up it look. But Harry, he went up to him and he said, "No, is that all right? And we'd better not touch anything." So we went back to downstairs. She was still sitting that same way. Has anybody been notified? I asked. No, she's unconcerned. Who did this, Mrs. Wright? Said Harry. He said it businesslike, and she stopped plating off her apron. I don't know, she says. You don't know, says Harry. Yes, I see, but I was on the inside. Somebody slipped a rope around his neck and strangled him, and you didn't wake up? Says Harry. I didn't wake up, she said after him. We must look as if we didn't see how that could be, for after a minute she said, I sleep sound. Harry was going to ask her more questions, but I said, maybe we ought to let her tell her story first to the coroner or the sheriff. So Harry went fast as he could to River Place, where there's a telephone.
Right, so, and what did Mrs. Wright do when she knew that you had gone for the coroner?
She moved from that chair to this one over here and just sat there with her hands held together and looking down. I got a feeling that I ought to make some conversation, so I said I had come in to see if John wanted to put in a telephone, and at that she started to laugh, and then she stopped and looked at me, scared. I don't know, maybe it wasn't scared. I would like to say it was. Soon Harry got back, and then Dr. Lloyd came, and you, Mr. Peters, and so I guess there. That's all I know that you don't.
So, right. I guess we'll be upstairs first, and then out to the barn and arrive there. Curious, you are convinced that there is nothing different here? Nothing that would point to any motive?
Nothing here, but hidden things.
Here is a nice mass.
Oh, her fruit. Is it fresh? She worried about that when it turns out cool. She set the fire go out and her jar will break.
Well, can you beat the women? Help for the mother and worrying about her preservers?
Yes, before we do, she may have something more serious than preserves to worry about.
Well, women are used to worrying over trifles.
And yet, for all the bullies, what will we do with the ladies? Oh, dirty towels. Not much of a skipper, what you say, ladies?
There's a great deal of work to be done and from.
To be sure, and yet... I know there are some country from houses which do not have such royal tower.
The towels get dirty awful quick. Men's hands aren't always as clean as they might be.
Oh, loyal to your size. I see, but you and Mrs. Wright will be fools. So I suppose you are friends too.
I've not seen much of her of late year. I've not been in this house it more than a year.
What is that? You didn't like her?
I like her well enough. Farmer's wife have their hands full, Mr. Henderson, and then?
Yes?
It never seems a very careful place.
No, it's not cheerful. I shouldn't say she had a homemaking instinct.
Well, I don't know as Reich helped either.
You mean that they didn't get on very well?
No, I don't mean anything, but I don't think a place be any carefuler for John Reich being in it.
I'll let you talk more about that a little later. I want to get laid off things upstairs now.
I suppose anything Mrs. Peters does be alright. She was to take in some clothes for her, you know, and a few little things we left in such a hurry yesterday.
Yes, but I would like to see what you take with us and keep an eye out for anything that might be a blue spot.
Yes, Mr. Henderson.
I have to have men coming into my kitchen, snooping around and criticizing.
Of course, that's their duty.
That is all right, but I guess that deputy sheriff that come out to make the fire might have got a little of this on. Which I thought of that tanner seems meant to talk about her for not having things secret up when she had come away in such hurry.
She had great sex.
She was going to put this in the it's same about her friend. I wonder it is all gone. I think there's some hair here that's all right, Miss Mrs. Peters. Yes, here. I desire, I believe that the only one. She feel awful bad after all her hair work in the hot weather. I remember the afternoon I put up my carriage last summer.
Well, I must cut the strings from the front door closet. You coming with me, Mrs. L? You could help me carry them. Boy, it's cool in there.
Mike was close. I think maybe that's why she keeps so much to himself. She didn't even belong to the ladies' aid. I suppose the felt she couldn't do her part. And then you don't enjoy things when you feel shabby. She used to wear pretty clothes and be lively. When she was mini foster, one of the town girls singing in the choir. But that was 30 years ago. This all you was to take it?
She said she won an apron. Funny thing to won, for there isn't much to get you dirty in jail. Good as new. I supposed to make her feel more natural. She said they was in the top drawer in this cupboard. Yes, here. And then her little shawl that always hung behind the door. Yes, here it is.
Mrs. Peters?
Yes, Mrs. Hill?
Do you think she did it?
Oh, I don't know.
I don't think she did. Asking for an apron and her little self worrying about her friend.
Mr. Peters says it looked bad for her. Mrs. Henderson is awful, sarcastic in her speech, and he will make fun of her saying she didn't wake up.
I guess John Wright didn't wake when they were sleeping that rug under his neck.
No, strange. It must have been done awful crafty and still. They say it was such a funny way to kill a man, rigging it all up like that.
That's just what Mr. Hale said. There was a gun in the house. He says that what he can't understand.
Mr. Henderson said coming out that what was needed for the case was a motive. Something to show anger or sudden feeling.
Well, I don't see any signs of anger around here. It's white to hear. Wonder how they are finding things upstairs. I hope she had it a little more red up there. You know, it seemed kind of sneaking, locking her up in town and then coming out here and trying to get her own house to thumb against here.
But Mrs. L, the law is law.
I suppose this. Better loosen up your things, Mrs. Peters. You won't fail them when you go out.
She was pacing a girl.
It's a love cabin pattern. Pretty, isn't it? I wonder if she was going to quiet it or just know it.
I wonder if she was going to to kill it or just not it.
Fresh fire didn't do much hard there, did it? Well, let's go off to the barn and get that clear.
I don't know if there anything so strange. Our taking up our time with little things while we are waiting for them to get the evidence. I don't see as it's anything to laugh about.
Of course they've got important things on their mind.
Mrs. Peters, look at this one. Here, this is the one she was working on. And look at the searing. All the rest of this has been so nice and even. And look at this. It's all over the place. Why? It looked as if she didn't I know what she was about.
What you doing, Mrs. Hill?
Just pulling out a stitch or two that's no seared. Very good. But searing always made me feel guilty.
I don't think we ought to touch things.
I just finished up this end, Mrs. Peters.
Yes, Mrs. Hill.
What do you suppose she was so nervous about?
Oh, I don't know. I didn't know as she was nervous. I said that so awful queer when I'm just tired. Well, I must get these things wrapped up. They might be true sooner than we think. I wonder when we can find a piece of paper and strings.
In that cupboard, maybe.
Why here is a bird key? Did she have a bird, Mrs. Hill?
I don't know whether she did or not. I've not been here for so long. There was a man around last year selling canary cape. But I don't know as she took one. Maybe she did. She used to sing real pretty himself.
Why? Look at this door. It's broke. One thing is falling apart.
Looks as if someone must have been roped with it.
Why? Yeah.
I wish if they going to find any evidence, they be about it. I don't like this place.
But I'm awful glad you come with me, Miss Hill. It would be lonesome for me sitting here alone.
It would. Wouldn't it? But I tell you what I do is, Mrs. Peters, I wish I had come over sometimes when she was here. Wish I had.
But of course you are awful busy, Mrs. Hale. Your house and your children.
I could come, I stayed away because it weren't careful. And that's why I ought to have come. I've never liked this place. Maybe because it's down in a hollow and you don't see the road. I don't know what it is, but it's a lonesome place and I always was. I wish I had come over to see Minnie Foster. Sometimes I can't see no.
Well, you mustn't approach yourself, Mrs. Hill. Somehow, we just don't see how it is with other folks until something's come up.
Not having children makes less work, but it makes a quiet house. And right out to work all day. And the company when he did come in. Did you know John Reich, Mr. Peters?
Not to know him. I've seen him in town. They say he was a good man.
Yes, good, he didn't drink, and kept his word as well as most, I guess, and paid his debts. But he was a hard man, Mrs. Peters. Just to pass the time of day with him, like a raw wine that gets to the bone. I still think she would wanted a beer, But what you do suppose when with it?
I don't know. Unless it got sick and died.
You weren't raised around here. Where are you? You didn't know her?
Not till they brought her yesterday.
She comes to think of it. She was kind of like a bird himself. Real sweet and pretty, but kind of tame and fluttery. How she did change. Tell you what, Mrs. Patterns, why don't you take the quilt in with you? It may take up her mind.
Why? I think that's a real nice idea, Mrs. Hill. There couldn't possibly be any objection to it, Colonel. Now, just what will I take? I wonder if her page are in there and her things.
Here's some read. I expect this has good saving things in it. What a pretty book. Looks like something somebody will give you. Maybe her key source are in here. There's something wrapped up in this piece of silk.
Why this isn't her kissers?
Oh, Mrs. Peters,
it's the bird.
But Mrs. Peters, look at it. It's neck. Look at this neck. It's all other side too.
Somebody wrung its neck.
Oh, no. Well, lady, have you decided whether she was going to quilt it or not it?
We think she was going for not it.
Well, that's interesting, I'm sure. Well, has the bird has flown?
We think the cat got it.
The cat? A cat?
Well, not now. There's Prestiff.
Well, no signs at all of anyone having come to our site and our group. Now let's go up again to go over it case by case. It would have been someone who knew just there.
She liked the bird. She was going to bury it in that pretty box.
When I was a girl, my kitten, there was a boy took a hit and before my eyes, and before I could get there, if they hadn't helped me back, I would have hurt him.
I wonder how it would seem never to have had any children around. No, Rike wouldn't like the bird, a thing that sang. She used the thing, he killed that too.
We don't know who killed the bird.
I knew, John Rike.
It was an awful thing was done in his house, and that night, Mrs. Hale, killing a man whilst he slipping a rope around his neck and choked the life out of him.
His neck choked the life out of him.
We don't know who killed him. We don't know.
If there have been years and years of nothing, then a bird to sing to you, it would be awful. Still, after the bird was still.
I know what stillness is. When we homestead in Dakota, my first baby died after he was 2 years old, and me with no other than.
How soon do you suppose they all be through, looking for the evidence?
I know what stillness is. The law has got to punish crime, Mrs. Hale.
I wish you'd seen Minnie Foster when she wore a white dress with blue ribbons and stood up there in the car and sun. Oh, I wish I'd come over here once in the white. That was crime. That was a crime. Who's going to punish that?
We mustn't take on.
I might have known she needed help. I know how things can be for a woman. I tell you, I swear, Mrs. Peters, we live close together and we live far apart. We all go through the same thing. It's all just a different kind of the same thing. If I was you, I wouldn't tell her friend was gone. Tell her it ain't. Tell her it's all right. Take this in to prove into her. She may never know whether it was broke or not.
It's a good thing the man couldn't hear us. Wouldn't they just know? Getting all stirred up over a little thing like a dead canary. As if that could have anything to do with Lola and love.
Maybe they won't. Maybe they wouldn't.
No, Peters. It's all perfectly fine. It's perfectly clear, is it? Except a reason for doing it. The teenagers, when it comes to women, if there was some finding, something to show, something to make a story about, I think they would come up with a strange way of doing it.
Well, I've got a team around. Pretty cold out there.
Well, I'm going to stay here a while by myself. Sheriff, you can send Franks out for me, can't you? I want to go over everything. I'm not satisfied, Dad. But, you know, we can't do this part.
Do you want to see Mrs. Peters? It's going to take him.
Oh, because they know very dangerous thing the ladies have picked out. No, Mrs. Peters doesn't need to be fighting, and for that matter, Sheriff's wife is never to the low. Everything of that way, Mrs. Peters?
Not just that way.
Married to the law. I just want you to come in here a minute. George, we ought to take a look at these windows.
Window.
We will write out Mr. Holly.
Hale goes outside. The sheriff follows the county attorney into the other room. Then Mrs. Hale rises, hands tied together, looking intensely at Mrs. Peters. His eyes make a slow turn, finally meeting Mrs. Hale's. A moment Mrs. Hale holds her, then her own eyes point the way to where the book is consulted. Suddenly, Mrs. Peters turns back well to pieces and tries to put the box in the bag she is wearing. It is too big. She opens the box, starts to take the bird out, cannot touch it, goes to pieces, stands there, helpless. Sort of not turning into the other room, Mrs. Hale snatches the box and puts it in the pocket of her big coat. Enter County Attorney and the sheriffs.
Well, Henry, at least we found out that she was not going to quilt it. She was going to... What is it you call it, ladies?
We call it Knowit, Mr. Henderson.